13 hippie animals. Want to learn about some of the slowest, laziest animals on the planet? Here's some creatures that in some way, shape, or form are similar to lovable, stereotypical hippies. Hey, any excuse we can find to make a video about animals is a good one, because it's always fun to learn new stuff about random creatures. Number 13, hippie chimps. Some call bonobos hippie chimps for one very specific reason. This may be a little risque for YouTube, but it's animals, so we're all good, right? Hopefully. But anyways, these animals diffuse social tensions not with physical fights like most other monkeys, but with an impressive repertoire of sexual acts. Rather than release tension like a bunch of mindless gladiators, they go more the way of the Kama Sutra, sometimes coupling repeatedly in the process. They've also been known to share their food with total strangers and stay closer to their mothers than the closely related chimp.
Number 12.
Sugar junkies. Sugar gliders are totally awesome. They're endemic to Australia, New Guinea, and a few Indonesian islands. They're very similar to the flying squirrel, which is just a quirky coincidence of evolution. Obviously, it can glide, and obviously again, it prefers sugary foods, like most of us. So do you want one of these guys as a pet? It's actually possible. Most states in the United States, with the exception of California, Hawaii, Alaska, and New York, and a lot of places around the world, allow them to be kept as pets, but we wouldn't recommend it.
Number 11.
Chickens. There's almost twice as many chickens in the world as humans. Wrap your heads around that for a second. Chickens don't really belong on this list. They're domesticated animals that have been an important food source both for their meat and their eggs for thousands of years. But they actually do belong on this list for one reason. They'll eat pretty much anything. If you live on a farm and are around pet chickens regularly, you may already know, but they're like dogs in that they'll scarf down almost any leftovers. We mention chickens as pets, which may seem weird to some, but they're actually awesome in such a capacity and can be tamed easily through hand feeding, just like hippies.
Number 10.
Hedgehogs. You can keep these cool creatures as pets in most places. Like a lot of stereotypical hippies, hedgehogs have very poor diets. They like to eat foods that are high in fat and sugar, meaning they're the perfect companion on a late night munchie run. This also means that they're prone, like humans, to fatty liver diseases and heart disease. Oddly, these animals can suffer from a rare disease called balloon syndrome, in which gas gets trapped under their skin as the result of an injury and causes the animal to inflate, making it like a basketball that needs air in it. Sometimes balloon syndrome can cause a hedgehog to appear to be twice its normal size. Someone deflate that hedgehog, dude.
Number 9.
Donkeys. If you live somewhere in the desert, where there aren't too many people but still a human presence, you may have seen your fair share of donkeys. Anyone who's seen them knows their slow, meandering ways. They're mostly interested in finding food and have been known to pillage the nearest human dumpster around. Wild donkeys, unlike horses, are solitary. Working donkeys' life expectancy varies depending on the circumstances of the humans around them. In poorer countries, they only live 12 to 15 years, while in first world countries, they can have a lifespan of 30 to 50 years.
Number 8.
Chameleons. The colors that this creature can be found in are truly far out and seemingly span every color in the rainbow. Most chameleon species also have the insane ability to change color. While they do sometimes change colors to camouflage themselves from predators, they mostly change colors based on the temperature or in social signaling. They like a warm, comfortable environment and are household pets of lizard lovers around the world.
Number 7.
Basset hounds. Ah, everybody loves the basset hound, the loyal, long-eared canine that is mostly found sleeping at a buddy's house. Doesn't everyone know someone with a basset hound? Well, if you don't, you should find someone with a basset hound, because they're one of the coolest, most laid-back species of dogs you'll ever meet. They're gentle, docile, and prefer hanging around the house, and especially like napping on a couch somewhere with their owners. While they constantly look like they're very tired as adults, they can be very playful and fun some of the time.
Number 6.
Ragdolls. So named for their tendency to go completely limp when handled by a human being, ragdolls are known for their docile, affectionate temperament and lack of aggression towards other pets or much of anything. These cats are so laid back that for a while there was a rumor going around that they were completely pain resistant. Again, just a rumor. If you meet one, don't think you could beat it up with no ill effects to the cat. They're compared to dogs because they tend to follow their human owners around and can even be taught to retrieve toys and do so with great enthusiasm.
Number 5.
Brown bats. Bats are scary, so you may be wondering, in what possible way could they be considered hippie-like? Well, much like koala bears, they spend a majority of their time napping. While they hunt during the day in the springtime and for a few hours at night during the other parts of the year, they spend most of their time conserving their energy so that they can catch their insect prey. Brown bats studied in captivity slept an average of 20 hours a day. In nature, they can be found snoozing away throughout much of North America.
Number 4.
Unwelcome tenants. As long as food and water is readily available, these creatures are staying put and it'll be hard to get rid of them. And it's not like they're going to be paying rent anytime soon. And no, we're not talking about that typical hippie, jobless uncle that crashes in their more successful brother's living room bathroom at regular intervals. We're referring to opossums, of course. Families of these marsupials often group together in ready-made burrows or underneath human homes. When they're caught, they don't want to fight. As a matter of fact, they will mimic the appearance and smell of a dead animal, a reaction that is involuntary, like a human being fainting.
Number 3.
World-class sleepers. Yeah, hippos really enjoy their sleep, so much so that they get at least 16 hours of it every single day. That's a lot of sleep, but what's even crazier is how they sleep. They tend to take naps in large groups of up to 30. They sleep on land like most other land-bound creatures, but they can also sleep underwater. Of course, they have to rise to the surface for air, but they can stay asleep while doing so, which is pretty awesome.
Number 2.
This dreadhead alpaca. This alpaca is looking a lot like he's ready for a reggae festival, or maybe just a bath. Alpacas are pretty heady in that their fleece makes for a great natural hypoallergenic fiber. It's not as prickly and a lot warmer than a similar material, sheep's wool. They have a funny way of eating. They chew in a figure eight motion before swallowing their food. One of their behaviors is pretty gnarly. They spit up green, acidic stomach juices when attacking smaller predators like coyotes and foxes. Hey everyone, hope you enjoyed the thumbnail and the rest of these lazy, hippie-like creatures. Some may be a stretch, but there's something interesting about almost any creature on this planet. So hey, why not, am I right? As always, thank you so much for tuning in, and hopefully we catch you on our next video.
Number 1.
Koala bears. Aren't there some days when you just don't want to get out of bed? And isn't it best when you don't have to? Koala bears get to lounge around literally all day. They're famous for their ability. Yes, it's an ability, and anyone with insomnia would agree, to sleep for up to 20 hours a day. These marsupials are native to Australia, and don't really have to move around much for one simple reason. They're herbivores. The trees you always see them chilling on in pictures are eucalyptus trees, and their diet mostly consists of eucalyptus leaves. The fact that they're lazy and slow does sometimes become a problem. Whenever a eucalyptus catches fire, which they're vulnerable to do, unsuspecting koalas lounging on one of its branches usually don't get off in time. Unfortunately, substantial numbers were needlessly wiped out for their fur in the early 20th century, and today they're considered a vulnerable species. Come on, we couldn't even imagine hunting these adorable creatures.